Hey guys, welcome back to Post Series. I did a short video on how you can change or how you can see your pixel values as you're moving your mouse around in your viewer. I wanted to go a little bit further to show you how you can use those pixel values to grade an image. So I have a setup here where I sampled a color from this green trees, again by holding down control while my mouse is inside of the viewer. I went ahead and sampled a pixel for a value of green that I want to perhaps, I'm gonna grade another part of my image. I actually chose this little building edge and I wanna make this edge the same color green that I have here. So what I would do in that case, I would take a mental note of these values here, my red, green, and blue. You can also see the hue, saturation, value, and luminance as well. But for now, we're gonna just focus on these red, green, and blue values. And we're going to adjust this grade node so that we can match our building edge to this green pixel that we've sampled. Now, if you want to remove this sample, because as you can see, the color will stay here. But what we will need to do, since we want to match exactly to this green, we are going to have to sample one of these pixels because we're going to want to change this the pixel value that we select to match these values. So I oftentimes just go ahead and write this value down. If I'm going to do this process, I'll just write these numbers down so that I have them and I know what I'm trying to match to. So let's go through that process. I actually already set it up, but I'll do it one more time to show you guys. It's a little bit of a process. So if I have this value here where these are the pixel values, I'll go ahead and write them down, like I said, so that I can reference them. And once I have them written down, we'll go ahead, I'll create a new grade node so you guys can see the process that I usually use this for. And then we want that one to be our mask. I'll just disconnect this since we aren't going to use it. And now I want to grade this building edge. Now I'm going to draw a new roto shape too because I do want to go ahead and show you guys something. So I'm drawing a roto here. Let's see. And I want to see my adjustment. And for this example, I'll go ahead and attach this grade since I already dialed it in and it has some values. So let's see how this is looking. Now, if I disconnect my mask, you'll see that the image turns green. So if you're ever working with a roto and you're wondering why you aren't seeing, even though here in the viewer, this looks totally fine, but you're not seeing the effects of that mask inside of your comp, you might be wondering why not. And the reason for that is usually because the format of the roto shape is not matching the format of the plate. So what you would need to do is there's a down arrow here and we can adjust the format right here in our roto node. So we would want to make sure our roto format is matching that format of the plate. So we would go ahead and change this. And now we immediately see that that image turns green in the way that we were looking for it to change before. So if you're ever having those problems, make sure your roto format is matching your plate. And like I said, I did go ahead and dial in this grade and actually, so it's a process of, let's go through it. So you want to, I created this new grade, so did I? Okay. So what we want to do is, let's see, sample one of these pixels in the area that we're going to change. And again, we want to hold down control and click. We sampled a pixel. We now have these values here. Now we want these values to match the values that we sampled earlier. So that's why we wrote them down, because now we don't have any reference to that value because we have a new value selected. So since we have this now, we know that we want to adjust, I'll actually just leave this here. We want to adjust our red green, and blue values until these values are similar to what we had before. So since I wrote them down, I'll go ahead and I'll start dialing my red down. I think the value we had was 233. So we have 2, 3. Then you just keep adding new digits. You probably need like 4, 2, 3, 3, 5, 3. So we have a little bit too many. There we go. So that was our old red value. And now our green value was 0.38. So let's go down till we get to 38331. So let's see. Can we get that with 2? No, we probably need another one. Maybe we'll just add another one just to dial it in. 3, 3. So we want 3. Did it go too far? Okay. 3, 3, 1. And then we might need another one. There we go. So we dialed in our red and our green, and now we'll dial in our blue. Our blue value was 0.0. So we have to go way down. 0.06. 837. So let's keep going. 0.06. We might just add another 2 just to get it in there. 0.06. 837. So we want to go up to 8. We want to go down to 3. And then down to 7. So we'll just dial this down to 7. So now we have actually adjusted this grade and we adjusted these pixel values. Now all of the pixel values of course will vary because we only sampled one, but overall we can see that we're having this same green right away, and all we had to do was to make sure that our values were matching. So this is a very good way that I use sometimes when I'm trying to match a very specific color. I just go ahead, sample some pixels that match the color that I'm trying to get to, and then I dial it in this way of adjusting, you know, on a like point, like very specific number basis until I'm getting this the exact same values down here, and that'll usually get you close. And of course, you know, you might need to adjust this if you're looking for something different, but this is a very quick and easy way. Well, it's not that quick, but it is a very easy and simple as well as straightforward way to get colors exactly the same. So that's one good thing about having these pixel values throughout our shot, so that we can see exactly what colors. We don't have to guess when we're color correcting. You know, we don't have to guess or like try to figure out how to dial in these adjustments all the time. We could just go ahead and just sample some pixels, use that as our starting point, and to get us somewhere close, and then we can go from there.